Hi, this is Rosie, and welcome to Nonna Stitching Lounge. Today we're going to talk about making a traditional granny square blanket. So this is a little bit different than my vlogs. And I know there's a lot of granny stitch patterns, granny blanket patterns out there. So I don't really want to talk about making the square itself. There's a lot of tutorials that can give you the granny square, but I just wanted to let you know the process I've gone through to get to here. So I have made already about 40 of these little squares. They look like they're about 5.5 inches in square. So you can see there is no rhyme or reason on the color patterns. So how did I come to do this? So I got a request from my sister-in-law, who has a beautiful cottage up in Northern Ontario. And I had made her a blanket, a brunette blanket. And she said, oh, it would be nice. We're finishing the basement at the cottage. It would be nice to have something more rustic. And I said, well, what about a traditional granny square blanket? And she thought, oh, that would be great. And I said, what about the Roseanne Barr granny square blanket, which you will see on her couch in the show, in the old show, and I think they recreated it for the new show that has now changed names and all that stuff. And I started preparing for it. I went through a couple of different phases where I thought, oh, I'm going to do maybe just three colors and, you know, make the middle all the same and make maybe not use black in the background and all that. Anyway, like, long story short, I've decided I saw a picture and I'm going to do the traditional black border. These squares have, you'll see this one has three colors. I change every round, and then all of them have the black border. So then when I join them, I'm going to join them with the black. And yes, that will be fun. As we know, black is really hard to crochet with. But I'm going to show you actually what I bought that helps me do that. Okay, but first, I just wanted to show you the colors that I have picked. You'll see what you've seen in some of the... So here I have these are nine of them. One, two, three, four, five. I think they're nine. Eight. Two, four, six, eight. Eight colors. So I have the burgundy, an orange, it's a white, baby blue, yellow, green, hot pink, and a light pink. And I also, which didn't fit in the basket, a blue, a navy blue. And then of course, the black to do the round. All the colors except two are Red Heart Super Saver. Okay, so it's just a worsted weight Red Heart Super Saver. I did have to go online to order these colors. The only ones I could find in either Walmart or Michaels was the navy, this burgundy, which I used in my other blanket, which I'll show you done in another video, and a gray. I'm not sure if they had the navy or not. Anyway, I can't remember. But all these other, like the bright pink, the green, yellow, blue, all those had to be ordered online because Michaels nor Walmart had a really nice selection of these colors. And I really wanted something to pop in the granny square blanket. Now, this orange and this pink are actually... they are not Red Heart. They're called Never Enough Craft Mart. And I think it's a Michaels brand. It's their cheap Michaels brand. And these were on sale. This pink and orange were on sale for $3.97. I think I showed you in a yarn haul. But I'll tell you, I'll never buy them again. It's funny because they just split, and you can tell they're really cheapy. Mm. So I think it's fine to just do like one row on a granny square, but I don't think that I would make anything else with it. It's kind of, yeah, it's yucky, as my 4-year-old granddaughter would say. They're not very nice. Like, you can tell the square is different when you make it, even just with the red heart, but then when you add this pink or this orange, I mean, the color is bright, but... So that's... And then I got this cute basket. Pittsburgh Steelers. Yes, a Pittsburgh Steeler basket's blown out. Anyway. My husband is a big Pittsburgh Steeler fan. Yes, we're Canadian, but... Yeah, that's his NFL team. So I bought this, and he wasn't using it, so I thought, what a great place. So now I can just pull the color I want and kind of pull at random, the middle, the second color, the third color, and then, of course, the last color is black. So one of the things I wanted to show you, and I don't know where I put it now. Did I finish it? Oh. So what I do is I change colors on every row, I was telling you. I cut off the color, and then I attach to another corner, and I do the second color all the way around, and then cut it off, and then attach the third color in a corner. I tie a knot, and then I crochet all the way around, and then do the same for the black. After every square, I sew the ends in, and I cut them off. So I'm doing that after every square, so that because I don't think I could do it after finishing the whole blanket. I would just be like, oh, I can't do this anymore. So I like to do it after every square. So I've got about 40 made, I think, and I think it's only about a third of the blanket. I lay them out once in a while just to see if I've ever duplicated a color pattern, and thus far have never duplicated a color combination. So I've use these colors, but not necessarily in this order, which I think is really interesting. If it were just up to me, I'd be doing like the same center in everyone, or I'd be doing the same outside in everyone, and then maybe just changing it here and there. But I thought I'm going to go totally random and do like random colors. But again, the fun part for me right now is like they get made, they're cute. The fun part is actually just trying never to repeat the combinations. So that's kind of fun. So, and then I cut off all the ends, and here is I have a yarn bowl that I bought a long time ago, and my husband laughed and laughed at me saying, what the hell are you doing with that? I was like, what are you doing with that? Anyway, because I don't often wind my balls anyway, so so right now I'm using it for scraps. Those are all the scraps from the ends that I've been cutting. So I heard somebody said that they sometimes use them to stuff anyway, you know what I mean. So that'd be interesting. Maybe I'll try that because I want to make some velvet bunnies for Easter. And the other thing I can recommend is, with the red heart and this yarn, I'm using a 6 millimeter or a J hook. I just think it adds a nice space around it. I think it recommends a 5.5, but, and I also would recommend really good scissors because I try to snip as close to the ends as you can. So really good scissors, make sure you buy those. And of course, I have this cute little Notions thing that I carry with me everywhere and has little, the darning needles and the little, those things. Anyway, I'm really having trouble speaking today. So that's it, friends. I just thought I'd come here just to tell you how I'm putting together the granny square and what my considerations were into putting these colors together. I did want to show you one more thing. Let me go get it. Okay, so here I am again. And I did want to show you, this is the bag that I bought at Walmart last week. Remember I told you I went out shopping, and I'm using this as my travel project bag. Now I've got stuff in it, but I wanted to show you. It has all these great pockets in there. It has outside pockets on both sides. It has, anyway, really cool pockets. I think it was supposed to be a diaper bag. So, but I found it in black, so that's kind of cool. And it's really nice size. You can carry, you know, a nice size project in it just to carry, go on the, you know, on the bus or the train or traveling wherever you're going. But what I really wanted to show you was something I bought on Amazon to help me crochet my black ends, because as you know, they're really hard to see. So this has three settings for each side, and you can adjust them so that they point to the fabric. Yeah, they're really cool. And this one here, I've seen them with the rechargeable batteries, but this one is just, you put I think it's a double or a triple A battery in, and yeah, that's it. And then they shut off. So when I was in the hospital for my hip surgery, I took this with me so I didn't have to need a lot of light in the room because I was sharing a room. And this has been great even just to do the black yarn because it's so hard to see. So I'll do another video when I'm ready to put them all together. Actually, I might do a video. I know I showed you in one of my other videos my cable textured sampler blanket. So I haven't put that together yet. So I may put a video together when I'm doing that just to show you how I'm going to stitch them all together. So anyway, thanks for coming by. Thanks for stopping by. Thank you to all my new subscribers, because there's been a lot because of all the great shout out I've had. I had another shout out by Jane at Straptastic Yarns. Oh, and she's a hoot. You guys need to go watch her. She is such a wonderful storyteller, and then she tells us at the end like weird stories that can't believe they're true. So yeah, that's Jane at Scraptastic Yarns. And I did want to give also a shout out to Leah at Handmade Crafts. She's a new blogger from Australia, and she's really cool as well. So thanks for watching, and thank you to all my returning subscribers. All right, so if you like this video, press like. If you're not a subscriber, it's free. You just have to create a Google account and then press subscribe, and you'll not miss any more episodes when I post them. All right, thanks everyone. Bye-bye. Ciao for now.